We'll start off with the peace mantra from Chandogya Upanishad. It's the meaning of this mantra in Chandogya and Talavakar Upanishad. Two Upanishads comes in Samaveda. Both of them starts with the same peace mantra. The meaning of this mantra, may the all-pervading principle enter into me. With this one, may the body be infused with energy. May the full of prana, may the eyesight be infused with energy. May I have a good hearing. May I have all the limbs be infused with energy. With this energy, may I dive deep into the contemplation of the scriptures. Many people, when they go read the scriptures, they are satisfied only with the outer meaning, and many people get confused and they become atheist. It says, in my study, may I never denounce the presence of the Supreme Reality. At the same time, may the Supreme Reality never forsake me. There should be a good bonding between us. With this one, with this blessing, may all the virtues mentioned in the scriptures come and repose in me. May the peace be in me, may the peace be around me, may the peace be everywhere. Om Apyayantu,
Om Apyayantu,
Mamangani,
Mamangani,
Vakprana,
Vakprana,
Chakshu,
Chakshu,
Shrotram,
Shrotram,
Athobalam,
Athobalam,
Indriyani cha Sarvani,
Indriyani cha
Sarvani, Sarvam Brahmo Upanishadam,
Sarvam Brahmo Upanishadam,
Maham Brahma,
Aham Brahma,
Nirakuriyat,
Nirakuriyat,
Mama Brahma,
Mama Brahma,
Nirakarot,
Nirakarot,
Anirakaranam Astu,
Nirakaranam Astu,
Nirakarnam me astu,
Nirakarnam me astu,
Tadatmani nirate,
Tadatmani nirate,
Ya Upanishatsu,
Ya Upanishatsu,
Dharmaste,
Dharmaste,
Mayi santu,
Mayi santu,
Te Mayi santu,
Te Mayi santu,
Om Shanti Shanti Shanti,
Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.
Last week we spoke about the new year, in the solar new year and lunar new year started last week. I mentioned about this year's, every year has a name. This year's name is Durmukha, Durmukha Nama Samatsara. Durmukha, the meaning of this one, the bad face, bad appearance. It's a literal meaning, but there is a deeper meaning for the sadhaka, for a yoga sadhaka. Durmukha, we have put on so many masks in our life. As a teacher, as a student, as a husband, as a wife, as a parent, as an employer, as an employee, and we forgot who we are. We try to imitate others. It's a meaning of this one. Take the layer one after another and discover yourself. That is the self-realization. Experience yourself, who you are. We don't know who we are. I think I am this one. Maybe I am this one in this life. What I was in the last life, I don't know. What I will be in the next life, I don't know. Realize what you are. That is the meaning of this one. Take off the layers. And it comes in the first chapter of Bhagavad Gita also. Bhagavad Gita is the foundation scriptures of yoga. In the beginning of the first chapter, Arjuna was very arrogant and highly intelligent and intellectual approach. And he says, take my chariot. In front of the people. I want to see who dares to fight with me. They underestimate my power. I want to destroy everyone. Ratham sthapaya me achyuta. Senayor ubhayor madhye ratham sthapaya me achyuta. I want to see who dares to fight with me. So confident, so arrogant. And in a couple of minutes, and highly intelligent, highly arrogant, and next few minutes, he collapsed. Krishna, I can't fight. My limbs are trembling. My voice is trembling. My Gandiva is trembling. And my body is trembling. I'm sweating. And he collapsed. It's a mood swing. He became very emotional. One side, 2 minutes before, very intelligent and intellectual. And in 2 minutes, he became very emotional. Mood swing. Big mood swing. And in the second chapter, it's Shri Krishna is tamtata. In second chapter starts with tamtata kripaya vishta ashrupurna kulekshanam kripaya avishta avesha avesha. He had put on a veil. It's not his own personality. He thought he is pretending as a very emotional person, a very compassionate person. It's a put on a veil. It's a veil had to be removed. How the veil can be removed? Bhagavad Gita went on after that. Bhagavad Gita is the process of taking the veil. We have put on various avesha, various veils we have put on, take the veils out. This is the meaning of Durmukha. It's a various veils, how to take it off. And the Shri Krishna takes in step by step, in various shlokas. We'll cover that one in the coming classes, how to take the veils off. And that is the one meaning of it's a Durmukha Nama Samvatsara. And the last week we touched upon, the Patanjali talks about in the Samadhipada, in the first chapter of Patanjali Yoga Sutra, another text, it talks about five qualities are required by a practitioner of yoga. One is Shraddha, Virya, then Smriti, Samadhi and Prajna. He talks about these five qualities are required for a practitioner of yoga. One is the faith, Shraddha is a faith is required. Whatever we have to practice, we should believe in that one, we should have a faith. Shraddha and Virya, we should have energy. Physical stamina, mental energy should be there. And the third chapter, it talks about memory power. Our human evolution happens based on the memory. If you keep forgetting, no progress happens. It's the best of the crucial point, whether we have good memory or not. When you depart the body, you should leave the body with memory, with thinking. It's not in a confusion, not in a, it's a, with a good memory, you depart the body. Smriti, we should have a good memory power. And fourth one, and you should establish in whatever you are doing the sadhana, establish in that one. And the last one, when you are established, that samadhi, the revelation happens to you. The uniqueness in you, that whatever you have put on so many veils in the past, veils starts coming off. The self-experience, revelation happens. That is the prajna. That same Patanjali, he took these five principles from the Brahma Sutra. In the Brahma Sutra, there is a sadhana pada is there. Brahma Sutra sadhana pada. It talks about four qualities are required for a seeker, for a seeker of emancipation, seeker of liberation. It talks about one is Shraddha. Here he talks about Virya, this Vairagya. We need to, Brahma Sutra talks about one is Vairagya is required, and the second one is the Bhakti is required. Third one he talks about it is called Upasana. Fourth one he talks about Jnana. It's a Upasana part. Upasana, I will be talking about Asana and Upasana. I will link that one in one of the articles. I am writing an article. It's Asana and Upasana. It's a Brahma Sutra talks about. One is Vairagya. See the limitations of here. If you don't see the limitations, we can't think of higher. If you are so comfortable here, we can't think of higher. Vairagya. We should have a Vairagya. See the limitations here. Aspire for something noble. That is called as Vairagya. And second one is Bhakti. It's a have love for the higher. You should allow that one, like that one. Then your mind starts focusing on that one. Third one is Upasana. Upasana, nischala manas. My mind should be not wavering. If I go to a lecture and that lecturer says yoga is useless, mind becomes, yes, I think yoga is useless. Anyway, people will going to die. What is the purpose of yoga? It's a mind. It's not nischala mind. It's not achala, favoring mind. Nischala mind. Set on that one in the yoga. When you go deeper, the upasana, that it's in the Patanjali talks about prajna. Here, it's a revelation happens. Jnana opens up. That realizes his own self. Brahma Sutra talks about that on upasana part. To have the mind to be established in that one. Patanjali, in the first chapter in Samadhipada, he talks about the four qualities are required by a seeker of a higher knowledge. It's Maitri, Karuna, Mudita, Upekshana, Sukha, Dukkha, Punya, Apunya, Vishayanam, Bhavanatha, Chitta Prasadanam. Chitta Prasada, mind. How to look after your mind. It's how to look after Chitta Prasadanam. Four qualities. Maitri, develop friendship with people who are always joyful. It's who are happy. Develop friendship with those people. Karuna, have a compassion for people who are in distress, who are in suffering. Help, extend your helping hand. Whatever way, it's go beyond your limits and help out the community, help out the people. It's Karuna. Mudita, take delight in things happening. It's anything good is happening, take delight in that one. And Upekshana, if anyone is criticizing you, ridiculing you, ignore them. Not to get into argument with them. So stay away from that one. These are the four ways Patanjali talks about how to look after the mind. Chitta. Chitta is a Chitta Prasadanam. And a Chitta also called as memory shell. How to strengthen your memory shell. When mana and buddhi, two things, mind and mana. Mana means emotional mind. Buddhi means intellectual mind. It's Arjuna in the first chapter of Bhagavad Gita. Highly intelligent and emotional mind. Beyond that one, Chitta. Chitta is the memory shell. How to look after the memory shell. How to strengthen the memory shell. Maitri, Karuna, Mudita, Upekshana. He talks about four principles. Yes, I want to do that one. I want to strengthen my memory. But Patanjali talks about there are hurdles in the path. We can't get the memory. We can't, retention memory power becomes very weak because of there are 9 impediments in our sadhana. We want to excel in our path, but there are 9 hurdles. What are the hurdles? We'll see that one in the next class. Lie down on your back.